that you are standing, and because you are crushed by your wrong actions and wrong intentions, that when you make that ruku, it is because you cannot carry your dirtiness. But out of the shame, you lift your head up, and the heaviness coming 10 times more, you have to go to sajda. Don't say, I'm facing my Lord. Don't you know? Even Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salam, at the point of Sidratul Muntaha, he's saying, I cannot walk further. Taking one step, I cannot face my Lord the way that you are facing your Lord. I cannot come. That is only for you. Today's people, they say, I'm standing facing my Lord. You don't. You face a wall, you face a tree. Don't think so much, who are you in front of that is showing ego to? You have to say, who am I behind? And there are so many who's in front of us, no? That they are facing their Lord. We are not one of them. We will be blessed if we are behind one of them. So that way there'll be safety. That way, even if you make so many mistakes, they will be able to carry you because you're not being arrogant. Not becoming arrogant. Arrogance will turn the most beautiful one to become the ugliest. As it happened to Shaitan. We want to be beautiful because Allah is the possessor of beauty. He's the creator of beauty. We want to have to look at the face who is looking at Allah. You understand? We cannot look at Allah. We'll be thrown into non-existence. Not even the angels are able to see Allah. They want to see Allah. But Allah is saying, you cannot stand to see the divine lights that is coming from me. But if you want to see me, go down into the earth and look into the hearts of those who remember me much. You will see me there. So where is the Qibla now? And where is the Kaaba now? What is more precious to Allah? The Kaaba in Mecca, or the heart that is the throne of Allah, that the angels, they may make tawaf around you to look. So people are also wondering why we love our Shaykh so much, why we want to look at our Shaykh. Because he is a man of Allah, he is Rijalullah. And what we see is only what he puts in front so that we can see him. If he removes that too, we cannot. We cannot stand in his presence. Because he's facing Allah. You understand? We cannot be also. So that veil that he puts, it is a blessing for us. So that we can come together. There is something there that is reminding us of ourselves. Otherwise, there's nothing there that can remind us of ourselves. Because they're already in that divine oceans. Yes. So our Shaykh has that. The Izzat. You have that. What do we want to be? We want to look. So that at least by looking, we will get some reflection, some splinter, some ray. That is enough. Don't ask for anything more. Don't be greedy. We say it is enough. Be humble. If somebody is praising you, say, this is not me. This is my Shaykh. This is my grand Shaykh. This is the Prophet. It's not me. Then that time, you can carry whatever that they put on you. If you stop to think that this is me, yes, it is right. Oh, it will crush you. Like I said, you cannot carry your burdens, you cannot carry your sins. You think you can carry the honor of what Allah has put on us. The believer. Because the believer will go crazy saying, I'm like this, but they're giving me this. How it can be? Don't say this for you. that time, what you do is you are slowly disappearing too. You say, no, 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 no. More you say, no. More they put, illallah. You say, la ilaha illallah. May Allah make us to become closer to our Shaykh, to see some beauty of his reality, inshallah, to give us more energy to become better ones. So that his reflection will be on us and the Ummah can see that. May Allah forgive me and bless you. Al-Fatiha. As Shaykh Effendi is saying, once you start reflecting that, once you start walking in the way of Allah, that time you're going to see a lot of people attacking you. As Shaykh Effendi said in the khutbah, who are the ones who are going to attack you? The closest ones first. This is just like the Holy Prophet ﷺ. Because you stay in the Siratul Mustaqim, and what the khutbah is saying, because you stay in the Siratul Mustaqim, and they want you to change. They want you to change into what they want. And you say no. They want you to approve of what they're doing. You say no. That time, they're going to slander, they're going to attack you. But that is the price of love. What else are we going to do? To give in? What are they going to give to us? Nothing. But we have to be strong and we cannot fear. That time you may find so many people leaving you too. It's okay, you have your Allah. Al-Fatiha.